Hello guys, hope all of you are safe and healthy. As many of you must be knowing that I have recently tested positive to COVID, but currently I am doing good. I have recovered, though my husband has tested negative, but both of us are avoiding going out. So whatever travel videos we are going to upload in coming weeks, it would be based on our past travel experience, as we are not planning any more travel unless the situation is better or until we are vaccinated. So I request all of you to follow the same thing. Unless something is very urgent, please avoid going out. So in today's videos, I am going to talk about two travel agencies that we had very bad experience with when we planned our Sikkim trip. But before I start, I would just like to request one more thing. I see many people just are viewing our videos but not subscribing to our channel. So if you haven't done it already, please subscribe to our channel, as it will really help us to grow our channel. Without further delay, let's just jump into the experience that I wanted to talk about. So in general, whenever we plan our travel, we prefer to do it by ourselves. We don't like to go through any travel agents, as we feel like planning it by ourselves gives us more freedom than going with a travel agent. But when we planned our Sikkim trip, we heard that as Sikkim is a border area, there is many restrictions in many places. You will need to generate a pass. Unless you are some localite, you will not be able to visit in some areas. So it's just you have to arrange a pass, and to get this thing done smoothly, it's always recommended you go through some local travel agents. I'm not saying that it is not possible that you cannot do it on your own, but if you want to have little less headache, of course it's going through a travel agent is a much better idea. So that's what we heard, and we thought, okay, so if this is the case, we have to find a travel agent. And before we reached Sikkim, just a day back, it was 18th of February when we were planning our Sikkim trip. So a trip was about to start from 19th of Feb. So it was very last moment and we did not have anything handy. So we were panicking a bit. So we thought, okay, let us just book travel package. That will be very much easier for us. Unless, I mean, at this point of time, probably wouldn't be having much time to plan it on our own. So we checked up on the internet and we found a couple of travel agents, and we have registered our number with some of them. And as soon as we have done that, we started getting calls from a couple of the travel agents. Itineraries one of the travel agents has provided was that was very nice, and it was actually going with our requirement. We liked the price and the planning they were having. So we thought, okay, fine, since this is nice, why not to discuss and try to negotiate about it a bit. So we started talking and we started negotiation, and finally we both of us agreed to some kind of amount. So initial quote they reached us with was somewhat about 15,000, but it was two nights and 3 days package, and it was supposed to be a private trip. So in this they will be just providing you a car, you will not be sharing it with anyone, and for 2 days you get to travel in multiple places. And the package was mostly for Lachen and Lachung, that is in Sikkim. So when we saw the itineraries we liked, and after negotiation we brought the package down to 11,500. They agreed on it, but they said, okay, this is what we can do, but since it is already late, we will be wanting your confirmation, and you have to pay about 8,000 rupees in advance, which is about 70% of the total trip cost. So I don't know why, I mean, in that time probably we did not give it much of a thought, and we checked up in the internet, and probably, I mean, we just saw the reviews of the travel agent, and maybe there was something that we have missed from our side, and we just booked the package, and we did not understand until next morning that probably this was not a good idea. We started looking up more about the company in the internet, which actually we should have done before we booked the package. So we found out the company doesn't have much of reviews in about their website. The other companies that we were reading reviews about was kind of having a similar name, but it is not the same company. So after that, we even checked up with the hotel that they say they will be booking for us. That was not also, we have tried contacting with that hotel, and they said we don't know any travel agents with this name. So yeah, so we actually started raising doubts in our mind. So we were even getting panicked that already we have started our journey, and then we did not have anything. We were just aimlessly traveling. We started from Siliguri. We have taken a shared cab to Sikkim, and in the way, like, we were just worried, what would we do, where would we go once we reach Sikkim. So we started reaching out to them, but we did not find any response. We did not get any response until it was about 10:30 or 11 in the morning. After that, the travel agent actually have picked up our call, but even though they have picked up our call, they were not sharing any of the details with us. Even though we have paid 70% of the amount, they were pushing us to do 100% payment, so which is actually not justified, as because you did not get any of the information. Even they did not share a proper invoice with us, then it was not justified for us to ask more money when already they haven't given anything to us. So however, very soon you have realized that okay, this was a huge mistake, and we are not going to get our money back at any cost. But still we kept trying. When we up to some point, the travel agents started saying things like that, okay, do whatever you want, because if you are not paying, I am not asking anything, that is not legal. But the doubt raises when actually you are traveling Sikkim, you should be needing pass, and for that at least you have to apply one day in advance. But until morning, until the same day morning, they did not even ask us our ID proof, taking which we should they should be applying for our package. So of course it makes sense that they were not genuine. They were just saying things that they are not aware about. So however, after some point they started saying, okay, we have taken away your money, or do whatever you want, we are not scared, so unless you are doing 100% payment, you are not getting anything. That's what that has happened, and we were very sad, as this was just the first day of the trip, and our mood was kind of ruined. So we just thought, okay, let us keep calm. We'll just reach Sikkim and we'll see what can be done, because I mean, after some point they were not even picking up our calls. And then when we reached Sikkim, we thought, okay, let us do an FIR, because if the company is not genuine, at least other people should be aware about it. Even though there is very thin chance that we'll be getting our money back, but still let us give it a try. So as soon as we reached Sikkim, we had to go through a lot of headache, as we did not have any hotels booked. We had to visit multiple hotels to find something. It was last moment, many of the hotels were already booked, and many of the hotels we did not like. We found an Airbnb and we have kept our luggage, and then we just directly went to the police station to file an FIR. And then we have shared the FIR copy and things like that with them, but still they were not having much of headache. They were like, okay, our legal team will look into it. So anyways, since we have gone there for traveling, we thought, okay, let's not just dwell into this issue what we are having right now, because there is no way we are having our money back. So why to spoil our trip? Let us just go and check for something else instead. At least we'll have our experience. So we started looking into the local travel agents. Before that, we asked them, could you arrange a share trip, which they said, okay, share trip is now closed as pandemic situation and all are there. But the share trip was available. Many of the travel agents, I mean, almost everyone was offering share travel packages, and which was just for 2,500 per person. And two of us, we just paid 5,000, which was including everything: our stay, our food, our travel, driver expenses, everything. So I think it makes much more sense than any of us, which we initially decided that when we were planning our Sikkim trip from Bangalore. That time we thought, okay, we'll just go in Sikkim and we'll try to find travel packages. But at the last moment, I don't know what got into us, we just deviated from our previous plan and we went through some online travel agents. So that was a disaster. People learn from their mistakes, so this is what our learning was. And like, this is just few tips that I think everyone should remember, that whenever you are booking any of the packages through online, please read as much as review as possible. And any travel agents, whoever is asking you 100% payment in advance, of course there is something wrong. In general, travel agents, genuine travel agents, will take a token of booking as an advance, so that they can at least hold on to your request. And the reputed travel agents, like probably the companies like Yatra, Goibo, whoever offers these kind of packages, you can, okay, no doubt you can trust them, but still always recommended that you just go to the place and you go to the offices of the travel agents, so that even if something goes wrong, you can come back to one place and you can talk to them. You can ask them, where did my money go and why they are not doing the proper arrangements. But when you are doing things online, it's kind of very risky. So it's very much important, before you are doing any kind of payment, you go through the website that travel agent is having, and try to read as much as review as possible, so that you don't fall into this kind of trap. So now, the travel agents that I have bad experience with, the name of the travel agent is Speed Travel. The Speed Travel, so they have a website in the internet with the name The Speed Travel, as you can see. So they don't have much in their website, but they have created a website probably to look it more professional. So if you are planning to book any of the package, so please be aware of this travel agent. And I will share the link in my description, so that you can know what is this website. And one more travel agency which is kind of reputed, still I would want to talk about it, because I don't think this is also a very genuine travel agent. When I tried to book the package, I registered with their website, which is the hallotravel.com. So this Hello Travel, take your contact and share your contact with all the travel agents that is there in the market. So the travel agent signed an agreement with the Hello Travel, and whoever client is reaching out to Hello Travel, they will be sharing the details with those travel agents. So this is how the Speed Travel got our number, because when I read Hello Travel's reviews, I saw many of the reviews were about how they have not given them the proper lead, they have given fake leads, and the travel agents have taken the money and ran away. So because of this experience, our trip was kind of ruined in the beginning. So it's always better you go there and then you book your package. It will be way cheaper, and also when you are going in a shared trip package, there will be about 10 people in a cab, and you actually get to make many friends there. So it's a nice experience. Someone wants to have private trip, then also I would recommend you just go to Sikkim and then try to talk with the travel agents and book the package accordingly, rather than just doing it online from home. So that's it, guys. That's all I wanted to talk about. I believe this would be helpful in case if you are planning any trip package in the future. If this video was really helpful for you, please like this video and do comment. In case if you have any question, also share it with your friends. In our next video, we are going to continue about our day 2 of Sikkim trip. Bye bye.